As the government reopens the economy further, public transport woes continue to hound the capital region. Among the issues, introducing cashless payment systems and meeting the growing commuter demand while minimizing health risks. For more on this, let's talk to Congressman Edgar Sarmiento, chairman of the House Committee on Transportation. Sir, thank you so much for joining us.
Good afternoon, Denise. Good afternoon, Ron. Thank you for having me.
Now, Congressman, you said free beep cards by Friday, but what happened to the people who were forced to buy the cards prior?
The proposal is that the 80 pesos load should be deducted from whatever cost of a fare from Monumento to EDSA on the EDSA carousel route. So we're hoping that this will be considered by the service provider. And what we're doing.
How about, sir, when it comes to the transaction fee, whenever the commuters would have to buy the load, are you removing that completely as well?
All of these, there is already a memorandum circular issued by LTFRB for the service provider that everything now should be for free.
So how about, sir, how do you think we can apply Internet of Things or IoT to transportation in the Philippines since we're moving forward with this digitally?
Yeah, moving forward, we want to use a QR code and whatever it is that could have the convenience of the riding public. Clearly, it's going to be contactless, brought about by this pandemic. We push it early, and Secretary Artugadi and the President has already spoken. Everything should be given for free. That's the standard right now of the House of Representatives.
Okay, how about, sir, the route rationalization implemented during GCQ? Has it proven to be more helpful towards the commuters?
There seems to be a problem right now because of the five routes that goes into EDSA. I discussed with the MMDA, we're hoping that again, the pleading of the chair of the Committee on Transportation to the executive, before they execute any plan, it should be thoroughly studied. You have a site inspection because we didn't want to execute anything that will have a net effect that the riding public will be inconvenient. We didn't want this to happen, Denise.
But sir, there's a lot of inconvenience happening with commuters, especially since there's a lack of jeepneys and also with PUVs. You know, what's the plan of the government on the jeepney operations? Is there really going to be a phase out?
No, we want to restart the economy, and public transport is a must. In fact, the feeding of the chair is to raise the traditional jeep to 50%, open up again the motorcycle taxi, and there's already the ruling of AIATF on Resolution 77. We want to address it by next week. And again, public transportation is very important, not only the zone, but includes besides and Mindanao as well.
Congressman, Metro Manila's 2020 population density was assessed to be much higher than other populated countries in the world, especially cities like Mumbai and Tokyo. Now, the expansion of the MRT and LRT are still in the early stages, and slowed down by the pandemic. Meanwhile, population continues to grow here. So what steps should the public and private sector take to effect solutions that can be felt by the public immediately, given the increasing need for effective mass transportation?
The population, Denise, the population of Metro Manila is 16 million. There's a data. Population of 13 million. What we're trying to do, we're trying to introduce right now what you can see is an EDSA, it's an EDSA carousel, meaning to say we want to move the commuting public rather than the buses and the jeepney working and fighting it out with the commuting. Again, the bottom line is we want to have a system that is the agreement of, that is the plan as well of the Department of Transportation and LTFRB to have cooperatives and to have the buses and the jeepneys bring the passengers, move them rather than competing in the street. And we're trying in the House, we want to file a bill, and that's a 30-year roadmap for the Department of Transportation and the transportation industry no longer to have the same problem that we had before. We want to move this country forward, and we're very thankful that there's clearly a cooperation between the legislative branch of government and the executive branch of government. This is the end result. Whatever momentum we have right now, we don't want to bring it back to the old days that we had before.
Congressman, can you give us like a short snippet on what that bill is about and when will you be filing that?
This is a 30-year roadmap. We already filed it. And this is, again, a study between the executive and the legislative branch of government. Not only the transportation industry, it includes the infrastructure, all these things that we need. Whatever you see in the other parts of the country or the world, we want to bring it back in the country as well. This is the Philippines. We want to give a bright future. Whatever the president is doing, Mayor Digong Duterte, we want to bring that momentum forward, and we don't want, again, that the circle of problems we have in this country will not move out of that loop. We want to make sure that the country's momentum will bring this country forward in the next generations to come.
That's right. Congressman, you're saying about you want to bring this country forward, especially with the current pandemic. But it was reported that four big PPP projects swelled the Philippines' contingent liabilities to estimated $312 billion. Do you think we need to rethink transport projects under the country's Build, Build, Build program and prioritize health project-related stuff instead?
These are well-studied projects by the Department of Transportation. That's where, Denise, if you notice, we're focusing more on rails. In Cebu, we have the buses. In Mindanao, we have the bus rapid system as well. These are well-studied projects, and I'm hoping this will be implemented as soon as time. But again, whatever mistakes we had in the past, we don't want it again to be back moving forward in the future.
So, sir, what you're saying is to still prioritize the projects over other health-related projects?
No, it should be together. You know, it's economic, clearly health. This is the problem we have right now. But transportation is a must. We cannot restart the economy unless otherwise we will have the transportation system.
Okay, thank you so much, Congressman Edgar Sarmiento, House Committee on Transportation.
Dennis, thank you, Ron. Thank you so much for the opportunity. Good afternoon, everyone.